Let's explore the Zoom Phone user interface on a mobile device. While I am using an iPhone for this demonstration, the user interface will look nearly identical on an Android device. From the Zoom app, tap on Phone along the bottom navigation. Along the top, you will see the subsections for Zoom Phone, which include History, Voicemail, Lines, and SMS. If you don't see SMS, that's because your account administrator has disabled that functionality. We will get to each subsection in a moment, but first, let's cover how to make a call. Regardless of what subsection of Zoom Phone you are in, the dial pad icon is always visible and does not change positions. To begin, tap the dial pad icon. Here, you can dial the phone number you wish to call. If enabled by an administrator, you can also change your caller ID or even hide your caller ID. If you don't know the phone number for whom you wish to reach, tap the small person icon to bring up your list of contacts to search. Tapping on a contact will show you the phone numbers associated with that contact, as well as the option to see their profile. Tap the phone number you wish to dial, and the call begins immediately. Once you have started to make and receive calls, your call history will begin to populate. To filter what is shown, tap the filter at the top to see all history, missed calls, or recorded calls. You can also filter calls to a specific line that you are assigned. In this example, I can see just the recorded calls for our customer service phone line. If you want to edit and remove calls from your history, tap Edit, select which calls to remove, tap Delete, then tap Delete to confirm. You can also swipe from left to right on a specific call to remove it. In the Voicemail section, you can tap on any message to see more information. Here you will see who called, their phone number or extension, and when the call was received. Tap the play button to listen to the message, and maybe even read along with the transcript. If the transcript looks a bit short, swipe up to reveal the rest of the transcript. At any time, you can easily tap to call them back, share the voicemail recording, or explore other options. Just like with call history, you can delete voicemails one by one, or bulk delete voicemails by tapping on Edit, selecting the voicemails to remove, and tapping Delete. For many, the Lines subsection may be pretty simplistic. Your phone line will appear here, and that might be all that you see. However, if you answer calls on behalf of another person, are a member of a shared line group, or if you monitor the lines of other team members, those lines will be displayed here. The final section is SMS, where your message history is displayed. To start a new SMS message, tap the pencil icon. Enter a phone number or begin typing a name to start searching your contacts, then enter your message. If you have access to multiple lines, you will be able to choose which line you are texting from. Finally, there are specific settings related to Zoom Phone on your device. Along the bottom, tap on More. Then in the Settings subsection, tap on Phone. Here you can forward your calls or toggle on or off your participation in any call queues or shared line groups you may be a member of. Tucked under General, you can modify the ringtones that will play when you receive calls. You can even pick a specific ringtone to play when calls come in for a particular number. Speaking of calls, this person looks oddly familiar. I better take this.